Hi friends. I want to talk about a book I'm reading today, which is Clarity by Jamie Smart. And this is a really interesting book because it captures a lot of things that I've been thinking about for the last couple of years, especially around the power of our unconscious mind. And this morning I kind of sketched a little diagram for myself about an idea that I've been thinking about for a little bit, which is that knowledge isn't enough, and action alone isn't enough either. And my problem personally has always been I'm an accumulator of knowledge, and I know a lot of things, but I don't necessarily put them into action. So it's possible to know something without truly making it kind of come real because you're not putting it to use, not putting it into action. But on the other hand, if you always take action and you never kind of learning from that action and conceptualizing it and turning into new understanding into new insight, then it doesn't matter. Then you'll never improve and learn. But on the other hand, if you never take action, you're only learning and focusing on knowledge acquisition, then there's no progress either. But now there's a layer on top of that, and I think that knowledge and action together are great. But if that's all you have, then you need a lot of willpower to take action on the things that you know. For example, you may know exactly what it takes to eat healthy, and you may even be taking action. You may be watching very carefully what you eat and taking a lot of action to make sure that you are improving your diet. But if you always need to put your willpower into it, then it makes it very difficult because you expend a lot of energy and a lot of mental resources making that putting that knowledge into action. And that's why a lot of people recommend these kind of habits. They say try something for 30 days and then you won't have to think about it so much. And the reason is because once you've done something over and over again, it does become a habit, a habitual behavior, and it becomes easier to fulfill it. And I think that the bigger picture of this whole question is actually I think maybe the difference between willful action and innate action, or willful behavior and innate behavior. When you do something with willpower, it's a struggle. When you do something innately, it comes effortlessly. And this is something that Jamie Smart talks about in the book Clarity, although it's is written in a style that actually is less intellectual and less conceptual and much more practical. He says there's not so much you need to apply from the book as just come to terms with a new understanding of the world, an innate thinking model, as he calls it. And when you have that innate thinking model, you don't no longer look for opportunities to use your willpower to make things work the way you are, but you instead relax back into a state of clarity, which is totally normal for you. And that idea I think is very, very powerful. And I think if, I found for myself when I let myself sit back into my unconscious mind and let that flow through me more directly, I can have a lot more impact on the world in the kind of ways that I want. And so, yeah, maybe that's something to leave you with. How are you letting your unconscious flow through you and letting your innate mind, your emotional brain, kind of make things a little bit more effortless for you so you don't have to struggle and apply your willpower to make things happen? I'm curious, habits, forming habits, of course, is one way. I'm curious if there's any other ways that you use. Be happy if you write a response video or just wrote me some comments. And yeah, that's the end of my second video blog. And I'll be doing more of these. So see you next time. Ciao.